Bueno, yo entro con Fast Public of Rosa Irme, that is further than just commissioned by Dr. Major B. Hansen. I just want to spend maybe 5 minutes just to sort of to say that we all have to be prepared for the unexpected. That's what these two small cases, which I won't take more than 5 minutes to say, be prepared for the unprepared. And I mean, many a time when we all admit cases in hospital, with the doctors, as soon as you admit a case, I say, what investigation should we do? That is the thing. Rather than finding out what is the case, they will say, what investigation should we do? That is one thing. Secondly, even now, senior consultants, when you refer a case, they ask for a battery test after that. Nobody is willing to give a diagnosis. These are the possibilities or the differential diagnosis, which I think. But most of them write out a further list of investigations to do. That is what we see in practice. However, object of this presentation is, this is a 75-year-old lady who is known hypertension with osteoarthritis, not a known diabetic. She came to a man with fever of 2 days duration, dry cough, no breathlessness, normal temperature, temperature only 99, cardiovascular system was alright, no failure, no anemia, and a few crackles on bronchi on both the lungs. Other systems are normal. I could have no idea, but I thought this is a usual case which we see in practice today. Because all of us see various types of flu in town. Any number of fever cases we are seeing for the last 3-4 weeks. I think every hospital is full of fever cases. And I thought this is one of the run-of-the-mill cases with the 75-year-old person with 2 days fever, temperature 99, no other signs. As a matter of routine, I took an X-ray. To my horror, this was the X-ray where I least expected a problem in this case. So, I mean, would other than Dr. Sai, anybody else would offer, I mean, only for discussion, 2-3 differential. When I saw this X-ray, I was quite perplexed to see who the X-ray is. I thought this is somebody else's X-ray, but this is a patient, 75-year-old, walking into the lab, saturation was all right, and this was the X-ray, the ECG was not all right. She was not hypoxic or anything, but this was the X-ray. Can anybody want to venture on a differential diagnosis? Or shall I go ahead? Okay, next. This is, I mean, the common things which we see is, one is a usual acquired pneumonia. Here we present patients with fever, tachypnea, paroxysmal opacities, there may be verbal consolidation, interstitial bronchitis, and antibiotics may clear this in about 6 weeks' time. It takes for the lesions to clear, it takes 6 weeks. Next. The cryptogenic organized pneumonia, this is following abrupt onset following the flu, fatigue, fever, weight loss, interstitial and bronchial disease, like a bronchoblast infiltration, normal opacities, and rapid response to steroids. Here we have to use steroids, whereas in the first case we can't use steroids, only antibiotics have to be used. Next. And sometimes in a 75-year-old person, you are always have to think of malignancy, although the presentation may be a little different, but the bronchoalveolar carcinoma should be kept in mind. Normal with bronchoblast alterations, and it can present that just as a pneumonia involving both the lungs. Interstitial lung disease always figures in the different diagnosis of a bilateral lesion. Of course, the tulisis duration is much longer. Basal keratins are there. Next. And adult respiratory distress syndrome, acupuncture. In this particular case, there was no respiratory distress as such. She came walking, her hypoxia was not there, but I think that has to figure in the differential diagnosis. Acupuncture was respiratory failure with bilateral radiographic opacities. However, in this case, the costophonic alignment has poor, and the severe marked hypoxia major was not present in this case. Next. And this was the CT of this case. And the CT also showed spindle picture like the X-ray extensive opacities, both lungs, spark consolidation and so on. Clinically, we have no way to establish a diagnosis except to ask for the doctor whether there is a eosinophilic pneumonia, you ask for the culture, you give antibiotic. And since the lesions were not responding, we did two CTs, but we couldn't see the response. Alternative was to wait for 6 weeks for the thing to resolve, or cryptogenic organized pneumonia, make a diagnosis. Clinically, the only other way is to do a lung biopsy, and how many of patients suffer, so we need to go for a lung biopsy. We give a small dose of steroids, and the whole picture cleared within another 3 weeks. She was totally all right. So the ideal presentation is, whenever we face a problem, suddenly you are, I didn't expect this 75-year-old lady to walk in and find out the lung lesion is so extensive. She had taken an X-ray over 6 months back, but that was quite all right. And this is suddenly out of the blue. Maybe cryptogenic organizing pneumonia. The second case, I mean, here also it was out of the blue. Yes, this 25-year-old male, asymptomatic man was going for a job to the Middle East. As a routine, I took an X-ray. Next. Here's the X-ray, and this is the shadow between the saw and the X-ray. As you can see, the rounded shadow in the supramediastinal area, upper mediastinal area. You can see the rounded shadow. This is also a surprise to me, 25-year-old. Yeah, I mean, it's very obvious. I mean, all of us are senior practitioners. It doesn't require for me to show it here. Everybody knows you don't expect this thing in a 25-year-old person. So this is the thing which took me by surprise. This man was planning to go abroad and suddenly you take an X-ray, because in Middle East, they are very particular. If you have a tubercular problem, they certainly send them back. So we took an X-ray, and to my surprise, this was the thing. And next. I mean, the common differential diagnosis which we thought was, could it be a thymoma, could be a common primary mediastinal neoplasm, can be asymptomatic, or cough, or vague chest pain. Pressure symptoms were there when they cause breathlessness. If the patient persists with a myasthenia, of course, then you can certainly think it is a myasthenia. Other uncommon things may be a mediastinal teratoma, a dermoid, which may show calcification and metalloclusion on the CT. And many a non-seminomatous germ cell tumor can cause such special symptoms. One has to always look for, even if it's a young man, Hodgkin, non-Hodgkin's lymphomas, should figure in the differential diagnosis. Intrathoracic thyroid mass, it may be a cervical thoracic mass, intrathoracic mass, which can present as a cervical thoracic mass detected and best detected on an isotope scan. And parathyroid mass, usually they are located with radiographic studies. Bronchogenesis can present like this. It's in the parenchymal region, as in this case. Patient may be asymptomatic. Infection can convert the cyst into an abscess. And the treatment is more surgical excision. CT scan will be the diagnostic modality of this case. And this patient, we did the CT scan and diagnosis of the bronchogenic cyst. The surgeon promptly operated in it, and the patient is all right. Thank you.
Sir, in the first case, you told about 72-year-old lady.
Yeah.
There's so much of extensive lesion in the lung. The temperature was only 99. Is it okay?
That is what it is. The patient was only 99. Patient had fever only for 2 days. And I was taken aback. I mean, normally we don't expect this thing. But this can present in following a flu-like syndrome, you have these extensive lesions.
What is the conclusion, sir? How did you conclude
that? I had to look into the differential diagnosis. Hey, what are the possibilities in this case? Patient is in, she's not hypoxic, she's not breathless, but the lesions are so extensive. And I had to give a course of antibiotics, thinking it will be some sort of a, it's an acute onset, so I know I'm dealing with infection. So I treat the antibiotic. The patient is not responding. And the patient is comfortable, but I'm not comfortable. So that is the reason we said, okay, tryptogenic organizing pneumonia can fit into the picture, give that. It's a clinical diagnosis. I stand correction if somebody else has an opinion on this.
Second case, there was no pressure symptom?
Nothing. Absolutely nothing.
But the lesion is in the CT is quite big.
It's fairly big. It's fairly big. Of course, he's a 25-year-old man, a strapping young man, in good health. You suddenly, if out of the blue, you ask him to go to Saudi Arabia, you find something else, then that is the trouble they have. And we should be prepared for the unprepared. That's the message I want to give.